Dawn will come, as it always has, escorted with pearls, the earth chalice spiked with frost. Sandwiched between your rivers, one lament and the other blood, the land will flame like a tongue of fiery green, threading the Sierras. The bull ring will pulse with blood, the red dust will still whirl and eddy across the road. Evenings will be as they were before, light rose or mauve shadow or smeared with iodine and chalked with the flight of cranes. Nightscapes will still be the same, bars of flamenco carried by the wind, goat herds round a fire, and sheepdogs barking at the rustle of dry oak leaves. Only you will not be there. Migration 3. We watch the rain descend on the flooding river. Brown rain on brown river, its muddy ripples kissing the underbelly of the Jamuna Bridge. We watch hut and shanty lining the bank move to higher perches, higher sandbanks, which themselves are turning wobbly with the damp. A sack of reined-in rice is moved. A shaggy dog droops behind the family, along with a calf untethered, its halter rope trailing from the neck. Birds are better off when they move from the tundra, their eyes closed, map of sky and sky route embedded in their genes. Through 10,000 years of shifting from the Arctic to the blue of the warm lakes, chills to waternut infested lagoons of the tropics. As the day moves into shadow and a kerosene lamp flickers somewhere in amazement at its own audacity, and the family looks at it as at a chimera, the river migrates to hut and hamlet. Thank you. May I also thank John Philip for reading and Monica for doing the first.